Good morning students, today we will start natural vegetation and wildlife. By natural vegetation we mean plant species that grow naturally in an area. Since India is a big country and the climate varies from place to place, India possesses a wide variety of natural vegetation. हमारे यहाँ पर कई प्रकार की नेचुरल वेजिटेशन पाई जाती है. ट्रॉपिक फर्स्ट ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट या इसे ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट भी कह देते हैं. तो ट्रॉपिकल एवरग्रीन रेन फॉरेस्ट आर फाउंड इन द प्लेसेस वेयर द क्लाइमेट इज हॉट एंड ह्यूमिड. वेयर द प्लेस विच रिसीव्स मोर देन 200 सेंटीमीटर रेनफॉल एनुअली. The trees in these forests remain evergreen throughout the year. They never shed the leaves. Thus, in India, tropical evergreen forests are found in the western ghats, Assam and hills of the northeastern India, and the Andaman and Nicobar. Mahogany, ebony, rosewood, and rubber are the chief trees found in these forests. Now second is the tropical monsoon deciduous forest. Tropical monsoon deciduous forests are found in areas which receive 100 cm to 200 cm rainfall annually. In India, this type of forests found in Ganga Plain, Shivaliks, the outer Himalaya, eastern side and in the states of Odisha, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand. They shed their leaves once a year during the dry season. Teak, sal, bamboo, mulberry and sandalwood are the examples of this type of vegetation. Next is the thorn forest and scrub or dry forest. Dry forests are found in areas which receive little rainfall. These areas receive annually about 50 to 100 cm rainfall only. Because of dry climate, trees which grow in these forests have small leaves to reduce water loss from the leaves. Such vegetation common in Rajasthan, central part of the Deccan Plateau, Gujarat, parts of Madhya Pradesh and in the plains of Punjab, bordering Haryana. Kikar, babool, cacti are the major trees found in this area. These trees also have a deep roots to facilitate the absorption of more water from the ground. Next is the tidal and mangrove forest. This type of forests are usually found in the coastal area, usually where there are rivers which flow into the sea. The fresh water from the river gets mixed with the salt water from the sea. In the tidal forest, roots of the trees are exposing during the low tide and they get submerged under water during the high tide. Sundarban Delta of the Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers are home to these trees. Tidal forests are found in Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri deltas. The Sundari trees is the main type of trees which is found in the mangrove forest. Mountain vegetation in the mountain, temperature reduces, one goes up higher. Thus the type of vegetation also varies owing to the change. जैसे जैसे हम height के ऊपर जाते हैं तो वैसे वैसे temperature भी change होता रहता है, temperature कम होता जाता है, तो इसमें जो vegetation का जो type है वो भी different हो जाता है. In the Himalaya we can find tropical deciduous forests on the slopes of the Shivaliks. Subtropical mixed deciduous and coniferous forests are found in the slopes of the main Himalayan range. coniferous forests grow at the altitude which range from 1800 to 3500 meters. Above these are alpine meadows, and this altitude refers to the tree line, as no trees grow above 3500 meters. Pine, cedar, silver fir, deodar and spruce are the trees which grow in the coniferous forest. Next is the wildlife. Forests share a mutually beneficial relationship with wildlife. Forests provide natural habitat to the many animals and birds. The national animal of India is the tiger, and because of the shrinking tiger population, it is also the most protected animal in India. Many tiger reserves have been developed in different parts of India. Tiger is found only in the Sundar Bengal. The Royal Bengal tiger is found only in the Sundarban Delta. The rhinos of Assam, the Asiatic rhino of Gir Forest, the snow leopard of the Himalaya, and the wild elephants of Assam and Nilgiri are the some of the species that are protected. Now, the National Bird of India, the peacock, is also protected species now. Many steps have been taken by the government to protect the Indian wildlife. Hunting is strictly prohibited in India for this purpose, and programs in prohibited in India for this purpose, and programs like Project Tiger, Project Rhino have been taken up to protect the species of wildlife. A large number of animal parks, wildlife sanctuaries and bird sanctuaries have also been established to preserve biodiversity and protect wildlife in India. That's all about this lesson. So dear students, do reading and try to film bookworm. Thank you. Have a nice day.